here we go. Customization, right? Yeah, we're going to be playing Squadrons pretty heftily the next few days. Today, tomorrow morning, which is the only time I stream on Saturdays. Sunday, obviously, is just Weeb Book Club in the evening. And the Monday, we'll be playing Star Wars Squadrons. Maybe some Genshin. I'd like to get some Genshin in, at least on stream. Because hopefully I'll have some progression at that point. And then Tuesday's Baldur's Gate. Ooh, there's U-Wings. Anyway, but you can, like, really customize this whole thing. And you can customize, like, the dashboard with some pod racer toys, like some Tauntauns and all that kind of stuff. Which you really can't on the Empire stuff. And we'll get more into this when we eventually get to multiplayer, but I want to finish the campaign out first. But I wanted to show you guys that this was the thing. While we hadn't looked at it yet. Just very briefly. Which brings a lot of questions, because, like, what's the point of customizing my character when we never see him, you know what I mean? Like, I don't know. I'm still not entirely sure with that decision. But yeah, so you get the Reaper, we get the Interceptor, of course. And if you try to customize, hold on, I clicked on this earlier and it didn't let me do stuff. You can customize stuff inside. Good. I was kind of bothered with this. I want to make the Interceptor look sexy.
Hoped you'd pick that.
Woo! That one's going to be cool. This will be eventually what I end up with, I'm sure. And of course, you can upgrade all these, but you need requisitions and stuff to upgrade it. But so, you do get like a fully customizable thing. You can get like little things. Okay, cool. I didn't see this. Dope. About how Star Wars makes no sense, you're just wrong. I got nothing. Star Wars makes a lot of sense. Droid head. Hanging flare, what do we get? Oh, nice. Love it. Oh, mini Rancor, look at that. Okay, anyway.
Excellent choice.
So, after having derped at that for like half a second, let's get back to the story. Don't talk to me about the sequels. Don't talk to me about the sequels. Big Pot. I swear to God. Don't open this bag. Because that shit made no sense. No, that actually makes no sense. I don't care about, like, it's a vacuum, chat. Okay.
All I'm saying is, instead of blowing up...
We talked to these guys earlier, but in case it unlocks something, I'm skipping it. Because we did this right before lunch. Yeah, Rian Johnson is a hack, and episode 8 should be retconned out. Okay.
First, congratulations. Well, the Emperor is a character. So, the false intel's with this bait.
We literally went over this last time.
Vanguard, your destination is there. It might sound.
Okay. Now let's talk. Can anyone become a Jedi? No.
That's right. This plan could knock Teresa
very much no.
Our tail. Sooner the better. Me.
It's very, very, very specific people that can.
He's put us in danger.
Can you earn? No. It's something you're born with.
The bigger picture,
having the ability to do. And then from there you can learn. But if you don't have the ability, you don't have the ability.
A smart man, but everyone has someone who can push their buttons.
No.
I wonder if we can push
it's like
hers.
0.1%.
We'll give Teresa a harmless convoy to follow. Play this out. We'll see just how far we can lead her. All about playing the long game.
I'm a long game.
When the Empire occupied Mon Cala, I learned how to string Imperials along. If you seem harmless, people underestimate you. I spent a lot of time around Imperials. playing the dumb alien. A bartender, a sweeper, someone safe. Next day, the Rebellion would know everything I'd overheard. It wasn't easy, but I learned to stay patient and wait for opportunities. Remember, the Xavian Abyss is no place for the faint-hearted. And Teresa knows a few tricks of her own.
Yep.
Keep your eyes and ears open, all right?
All right.
And the Starhawk's crew?
More than ready. I selected the crew personally based on their expertise and experience. They've been training for months.
That's good. I appreciate your support on this, General.
It's a good plan, Lyndon. Just be careful. I know you have a past with the Overseer's captain. Don't let it cloud your judgment.
One moment, General. Sorry, I can't talk right now. Your squadron is waiting.
Anytime we get to see more Hera, I'll take it.
So, the boss wants to pull the old bait and switch on Teresa. I must be rubbing off on him. Of course, the key to...
Hold on. I'm sorry. I forgot to switch this back.
Too naive to know better, or you think it's worth the risk. Like, say, stopping a Starhawk from being finished. Teresa Carroll's risking the abyss just for the chance to destroy some magnite crystals. Ain't she in for a surprise? I'm kind of excited to see our Starhawk tackle Teresa's flagship. All those engineers work their tails off to get it finished. That's one good thing about this new Republic. We're finally punching at the same weight as the Empire. One way or another, this is gonna be a show.
Oof. I want to talk to Grace. There we go.
I've heard tales of the Xavian Abyss. They say it's swallowed entire fleets without a trace. Sending our brand new Starhawk in there is quite the gamble. Commander Jade must have complete faith in its builders. And in us, of course. We'll be the ones making this ruse work, after all. I took the liberty of studying the Starhawk's blueprints. It's not just another capital ship. It's a defense against Imperial fleets. Every spare inch is packed with lasers and munitions, but what really caught my eye was the tractor beam. If I understood the blueprints, the Starhawk's tractor beam is 10 times more powerful than that of a Star Destroyer. It's incredible. The magnite crystals they use in the Starhawk's tractor beam are quite rare. I think they salvaged a few from the Star Destroyer we captured. My family spent an exorbitant amount of credit sourcing magnite crystals. It's so gratifying to see them go to a good cause. Let's put our new Starhawk through its paces, shall we?
Cool! I get to choose.
An X-Wing, Y-Wing, or A-Wing. They've all got pros and cons. Check the schematics and let me know what'll suit you.
I'm going with the next one. Not for this mission. I'll probably be preferring an X-Wing or a Y-Wing every time. Because I don't really want a U-Wing, and I don't really want to ever drive an A-Wing. Yes, they are. Vanguard,
protect that convoy and see you on the other side.
Space monsters are absolutely your thing.
Oh, you can feel it, right? Chaos on every side. We don't belong here.
I'd hate to see what does.
Hey, what happens once the Starhawk disables the Overseer? The same as the Victorum, I expect. Board it, lock its systems, and take the crew prisoner.
I That's good.
Oh, Grace. I can't imagine Teresa Carroll coming along quietly. I hate these clouds. Who knows what's out there?
We know what's out there. A Star Destroyer with a captain who wants us dead.
Real helpful. Thanks, Gunny. The convoy's droid autopilot ain't smart enough to steer through these asteroids.
Then let's blast them a path.
Wait, look. A Star Destroyer. Or what's left of one.
I'd say it's been here a long while.
You'd think this would discourage Teresa Carroll.
To someone like her, that wreckage ain't a warning. It's one more insult.
So cool.
Look lively, Vanguard. Imperial ships are on radar.
Scouts. Perfect. The boss's plan is working. Give them a show. Make sure they buy it.
That's a double kill. Hell yeah. Places. Have a good one.
We got ties closing on the convoy.
Y'all act normal. What do you mean y'all act normal? What happened, Chet? Also, hey, Trev.
You're good. Keep flying. We push them back. Let's keep going.
Vanguard, the Imperials scanned the convoy, but the Overseer's still on approach.
breaking up. Let's push on.
The ambush point is this way. Ready?
This is a trap. Without a doubt, chat. This is a trap! Are we gonna swap mid thing?
The overseer.
No.
Finally. We've drawn it in.
Nobody panic. This is the plan. Defend the convoy and keep luring the overseer to the ambush point. How could you challenge an Imperial Star Destroyer? Get those asteroids. If the overseer catches the convoy, it's toast. Guess Teresa decided to handle this convoy herself. I got the cold sweat on my neck.
Stay focused.
I am. I'm very focused on the Star Destroyer right behind me.
Oh my god, I missed. Gotta take out the missiles! Yeah, no spamming whoever the hell that is. Thanks, TY. Squeaker Remy. I'm sorry, chat! I'm not ignoring you, I promise! That's good. Okay. Would you guys stop locking? Thank you. They know what they're asking me.
Taking out our fighters one by one should be very distracting. Captain Carol to Vanguard Squadron. This is a futile gesture. You have nowhere to go, and I have no interest in prisoners.
I see him right behind us.
You're good now.
Chad. Can I get a resupply?
Mm-hmm.
coming in on the interceptor! Nope. Bitch. Not a lab! Got it. How are they resupplying you while you're in space? So many questions, because that's what resupply ships do? They're astro droids? Explain that actually earlier in the game. Can't confirm. Oh, shit. That was way too early. I fucked that. Also, how's Trellis talking? Because they're literally on the other ship. They're literally, like, airing a trap. Literally right here. No sound in space? There's comms in space? What? No, the space itself is a void. Like, yeah. Comms don't use sound waves, though. They use radio signals. I get what you're saying, Big Pop, but none of those complaints are actually valid so far. Big reaches, my dude. Big reaches. Also, that is... What do you mean, not valid? Because I've already explained all of them. They're logicked in the game. There's a lot of reasonable complaints at the Star Wars universe. None of those I've been so far, though. They're all explained. We're still the good guys. Anyhow we want, right? Wherever they jumped, no ship's coming back from that. Let's hope so. What is ships when they fall when they blow up? See, that's a good one. I think it has something to do with, like, how their hyperdrives actually work. Is something about, like, it's a self-propelled gravity sort of thing.
Where are we?
House of Rem. Remetic system. Grid L14.
How are we hearing the pew-pew in space? Now, that's a good example. Yeah. Because there is no sound in space. I think one of the explanations has been it's like lasers at a high frequency kind of thing, but not really.
There's an old munitions depot in this system, Captain, run by a Colonel Grawl. Must be our lucky day.
Make the call. This isn't over, thank God.
So, you jumped to my territory, uninvited. Then demand my supplies?
Colonel Graham, the Starhawk project is within our grasp. All I need is repairs and proper munitions.
No. The Emperor assigned me to this depot. I decide how its resources are used. As of this moment, that includes your stuff.
To be honest, you do in a lot of places.
The Overseer was sent on this.
It just depends if they were aiming for a rating or not.
Herself.
Admiral Sloan
kind of thing.
I have rebel guerrillas to
because they're normally aiming for T's, but yes, otherwise you would see floating bodies.
Grom out.
That's this game is still meant for families kind of thing, versus like, let's go for A. Or an M rating, there we go. A rating, Jesus Christ.
Well, lucky for us.
Man, Regulations specifically forbid this.
I will not be beaten by Vanguard, grandstanding imbeciles, or anyone else.
Please, not judgment.
It's just fine. Call in Titan Squadron. Now!
Yeah, I mean, Star Wars has always been aimed for, like, family-friendly kind of things, guys.
Well, that could have gone better. I never expected that cobbled-together battleship to be more dangerous than the Xavian Abyss. Those dockyard coordinates almost cost us the Overseer. Look at this place. The deck below is even worse. And did you hear? We're not being given the munitions we need to strike back. No wonder Captain Carroll's furious.
It's actually really interesting if you look at, like, the comics and other, like, I guess, books and things like that. Everything you guys are describing in those mediums is there. Especially when we're talking about, like, bodies from the Death Star and things like that. As long as it wasn't in the detonation itself, but, like, the TIE fighters and stuff around it, they were floating. Because a lot of people went back and salvaged.
There's always a way to win. The captain summoned us. Let's not test her patience.
But one of the self-explained things is its detonations of the view, the, like, when a TIE fighter blows up, right? So there's no corpse remaining, it's just barely even the wings and some scrap metal. That's the mentality, it's like they're vaporized. But you know what I'm saying.
Local rebel forces are preparing to attack Colonel Graham's munitions depot. You'll patrol the area in preparation for the attack, and keep the depot safe. Graham is a fool, but his assets belong to the Empire. Therefore, they belong to us.
During They're
control,
not.
Titan III will secretly search the station, its freighters, and cargo shuttles for Viridium. This explosive material will be a valuable tool against the Starhawk. Tag the Viridium, and LT-514 will...
That's a plot convenience thing.
While Graham is kept busy by the rebel attack, escort the Viridium to the Overseer for safekeeping. According to the Colonel,
Star Wars wouldn't have been as much fun if Luke got shot in the first 30 seconds, chat. Alright? Like,
it's a powder keg.
You get what I'm saying? That's why they don't hit.
We lose the depot, and the Overseer will be defenseless. Remember, as long as repairs are still underway, we can't afford to engage the Republic.
Where's the realism? This is not a franchise for realism.
And then we can leave the Remetic system. You're on your own, Titan Squadron.
All right, now you guys are just going too far. That's too far! Falcone, that's the point that's too much! Fuck Jar Jar Binks, shit!
I owe you and the rest of Titan Squadron an apology. When the Overseer was attacked, I realized that everything I know about war is what I've read. I'm beginning to understand how it must feel in that cockpit under fire. Terrifying. Yet you and the others risk it every day.
That's because we're cool.
Clearly, I still have a long way to go. I know Colonel Graham is in the wrong, and yet seizing his munitions feels drastic. But Captain Carroll is entirely correct that Admiral Sloan's orders supersede Graham's, and we are committed to work. There's much to do.